So good afternoon everyone, सभी को नमस्कार प्रणाम. Today we are going to speak on the internet. आज हम इंटरनेट के बारे में पढ़ने जा रहे हैं. What are the things, the starting of the internet, who evolved, means who started discover internet, what are the factors we'll be looking today. So keep with pen and paper ready. We are going to start. See, the internet is not made of two words. One is called inter, other word called as net. Inter means inside, net means network. Inside the network, inside means inside the globe. Globe के अंदर हमारा जो विश्व है उसके अंदर जो network है उसको बोला जाता है internet. Not your home, not your office, not your university, not your city, not your country. It is global. It may be Australia, it may be Japan, German, India, Russia, anywhere. Or it may be Pakistan also. So throughout the globe, it's connected by the internet. As you see the picture, you can see. See the globe, in whole globe, everything is connected by the internet. Okay, if I send anything, whether my brother is there in Japan, if I send something to him or her, she will get within fraction of a second. How it's possible? Due to the internet. So internet, it's not connected to the state, country or anywhere. It is a global level. And you need to understand the difference between the internet, intranet or extranet. I'll be bringing that concept in some other class. Just understand here, the internet is the global network, global level, not a state level, not a any level. Again, if you go to network class, network will be different types of networks will be there. For example, for your understanding paper, network will be like LAN. I think you heard about this LAN, PAN, MAN, WAN, MAN, WAN, all these different types of networks are there. Their internet comes under where? WAN, wide area network. Remember, I will be talking in some other class regarding this, but for your understanding, this is called wide area, full form, wide area network. Okay, so internet comes under that wide range. It's not in a state, it's not in your country, it's worldwide. That's what we call internet. Okay, wide area network. So it's known as the global network. Question mein pucha ja sakta sawal, internet is the state, sorry, private network, partial network, global network, all these things. So aapka answer ban jayega kaun sa hai, internet is the global network. First point. Now, the first internet was discovered. जो पहला इंटरनेट है उसको कब डिस्कवर किया गया था? 1960 में. 1960, very important point. And the internet name was that time ARPANET. ARPANET. Why ARPANET? Remember, ARPA is the one phrase and NET is the second phrase. ARPA means advanced. A stands for advance. R stands for research. And P stands for project. A stands for agency and NET stands for network. So the first net name was ARPANET, Advanced Research Project Agency Network. When? 1960 mein. So this is the second point for your exam. Okay. Now the father of internet, jab pucha jata hai ki internet ka jo srishti karta hai, kisne invention kiya tha, uska naam hai Windcraft. Remember, very very important question for your exam ICT. Windcraft. Or some other name also there. His nickname is called Winton Greycraft. But this option you will get very less in the exam. This name will be available in the screen or in your exam paper. Windcraft is the inventor or who started internet first, discover. Next very important question for you. The father of AI, artificial intelligence, that name is John McCarthy. When? 2006. John McCarthy. Very very important questions. Can you give the answer of any example of AI, artificial intelligence example? Any example of artificial intelligence? Okay, Google Assistant is going on at present. Very good answer. And one more example is here. I discussed in last class, Sophia regarding. Sophia means is a one kind of robot. 2018 they started that project. 2016 also started actually. So it was firstly started in Chennai, in India. So we are what with this artificial intelligence, one thing will be added. One is called MA, machine learning. So the machine learning means what we are doing here. We are teaching our high language to the machine. So machine learning there, so that we can quickly can what we want a robot can understand. For example, I want to bring the water. If I tell water, bring water, robot will go and he will bring. Now at present that is okay, but before telling your intention, like for example, I want to drink the, I want to eat some food. before telling me, the robot should understand that what, and he will bring the food. Okay, tomorrow I want to go to my mother home. If I tell, or my father home, grandfather home, anywhere, before telling, the robot should understand, he should arrange your vehicle and everything. So that is called the machine learning. Now artificial level, it's growing, increasing. So this kind of things are going on at present era. Before 2035, in India, almost 50% will be covered by artificial intelligence. 2035, everything, school, college, transport, everything. Now the father of artificial intelligence is John McCarthy, for your exam purpose, important point. Please note the point. Chalo, aage dekhte. Now the first, one more example is here, given here. The first point is WWW is World Wide Web, and you should not get confused. Confused mat hona. Internet and World Wide Web, WWW is different. Okay, WWW is the content, online content, whatever you are looking. Picture, in the form of picture, in the form of the letters, in the form of any video, anything, audio file, that is called the WWW, means World Wide Web content, online content, through which you are watching, through which you are getting that information, that is called the internet. Okay, internet, and internet is the network, global network. I already mentioned WWW is not the network, remember, this is not the network, this is the content base. Okay, and obviously for your understanding purpose, WWW is the first browser, first web browser. By chance they ask questions in exam, can you give the example of first web browser? The answer is WWW, Wide Web. Okay, now one more question to you. I asked in last class, can you tell the full form of WWW? 4W, WWW, full form of that. WWW, yes. That is World Wide Web WOM. Very good answer. Very good answer. So that's things you should know. These questions will be asked in malware part. Virus, malware, that related. So WOM, I'll discuss some other time what is WOM and what is bug and all this. Now remember, it stands for World Wide Web. Iska matlab World Wide Web hai. Kisne invention kiya? Tim Berners-Lee. Very, I will keep very star point. Very star here. Big star, IQ. In any exam, this question will ask. Tim Berners-Lee, he is the founder of WWW. Now, founder of internet is different. Okay, Vancraft, and founder of WWW is different. So both the things are different. Okay, but the thing is, he invented when 1989. He was a engineer in CERN. I already discussed CERN. It's a British company. CERN, one software company. He was a scientist in that company. Us company was scientist tha, Vigyani. So invention kab kiya? 1989. But he released into the society, in the public, when 1991 in August. So question may ask in two types. Question do tarah pucha ja sakta hai. Invention kab kiya gaya tha? Tab answer banega 1989 mein. Agar pucha ja sakta hai kab public mein release kiya tha in society, that answer is 1991. Remember, the founder is, the developer is Tim Berners-Lee. Okay, and that age from 1991 onwards till today, means 2021, okay, is known as the information age. Very important point, information age. Before the invention of WWW, it was very difficult to know everything. Okay, what my teachers told, that only I can learn. For my teachers told, like the Taj Mahal is located into Agra, I have to accept that only. If there is a WWW, I can easily can go, I can search whether it is Agra or Dubai or India or Pakistan, I can search. So that is called the information era or information age, when 1991 onwards. So for your understanding purpose, important points is Tim Berners-Lee, the founder, then when 89, the when it brought for the public, that is 1991. And that, from that time, it's known as the information age. Us samay se isko bolaya tha information age hai hamara. Theek hai? Chalo, aage dekhte. Now, that I mentioned here, see slight difference between the WWW and internet. What is that? See, the first I am telling about the WWW. So WWW is consist what? Web pages, pictures, videos, and online content that I mentioned. Online content will be there. It may be in the form of web pages, in the form of picture, image, or in the form of videos or audio. Okay, audio, anything. So that is called online content. In case of internet, internet kya hai? Internet is the network or connection. Okay, to reach all this content. This is the connection network to reach, to retrieve. Retrieve means to gain. See, I will use the word sometimes retrieve. Retrieve stands for gain. Okay, this is the technical word, retrieve. Retrieving the mail or anything. So retrieving means gaining or getting, simple word. So the retrieving the any kind of message, any kind of information through which network, that is called internet. That's why I all mentioned already, it's known as the global network. For example, you can get here the mail, to send the mail to access the worldwide www. See, the mail what you are sending, that is not the internet. Through which you are sending, by the support of which network, that is called internet. Okay, you are sending the mail, no problem. Mail is nothing, simple. In mail, you are sending some photo, image, video, that is called as www. That is the content. Okay, and the how you will send the all these things? By formatted some this level, HTML. This is one page. Can you tell the full form of HTML? I already discussed. That is called hyper text markup language. Keep in mind, hypertext markup language. In this language, nowadays, every page is made, every page. If you open a university page, okay, all Wikipedia page, any page, that page is made by this language. Which language? Hypertext. Hypertext means it's a high language. Before, all these things were there in machine language, means in binary digit, 0, 0, 1, 0, like this. It goes binary digit. Later on came the assembly language, like AVI, MOP, like this, it will be there. Assembly. Then later on came JavaScript and so on. Nowadays, it become natural language. So NLP started. So all these things, web page, website is maintained by the help of which language? The answer is HTML, hypertext markup language. So remember the full form, IQ. Now access via HTTP. And how can you access? By some rule, maintaining some protocols. So protocol means rule and regulations. Like yoga day protocol. Means rule and regulation, what to practice, what not to practice. What is the full form of HTTP means? Hypertext transfer. Okay. Transfer protocol. Remember, these are the very important point. Short form may ask at any time. I will telling you, please make one separate paper for the full form and short form. Abbreviation purpose. So at the end of the ICT, you will get minimum 4 or 5 pages for that. Okay, if you possible. Hypertext transfer protocol. By following this particular protocol, we can read all these things. We can gain the, or we can retrieve the information or online content. Okay, so I think you are clear with this. So difference between the internet and web and www. Should not get any confused later on. Okay, so again I am telling www is the content, online content. Through which protocol we are gaining that. That is called internet. I think you clear. Now, let's understand. Do you have any doubts? Quickly you can ask. Now, I will go to some other part. Doubt hai to push liyo. If you don't have doubt, you can keep no doubt like that. So, I can go for further. Chalo, no doubt. Let's understand about the website. Okay. Now, this website is made of two words. One is web and another is site. Web means, already I told the short form of www means web. Okay, I already discussed. See here. Already discussed. See the. Here. It's commonly known as the web. www, it's commonly known as web, web portal we used to say. So web site means one direction. So inside the web portal, some specific direction will be there to reach or to retrieve any information. How? See here, the collection of related web sources. Collection will be there. So many collections will be there, such as web pages or multimedia content. It may be web pages. So many pages will be there. For example, if I just open your book, in your book, so many pages will be there like this. If your book is like this, means so many pages will be there like this. So many pages, more than 150 like this. In internet also, means in www, in there also, so many pages will be there. Inside the website, if you go to any website, in your college website, if you go to NT website, Google website, so many pages are there. Okay, so there what will happen, you will get so many multimedia content. It may be form, it may be any kind of photo, it may be any picture, it may be any video, it may be any JPG content, or it may be PNG content, it may be AVI content, anything you will get. Okay, which is specified by a common domain. Domain means, I think you have seen, like .com, okay, then .in, .org, .edu, .gov. So all these things known as the ending part of the domain, ending part. Domain contain the full part, like for example ugc.ac.in. So that ugc.ac.in is fully known as the domain. Before that, so many things are there, like www.https, all these things. So these things are different. Our domain, I will bring one class for the domain purpose, special domain, all domains are there. So here, remember, domain means the name and the extension of the site. Name will be there, like ugc dot, that's the name, ac.in, that is the extension. So whole things, ugc, ac.in is known as the domain, particular. University site, if you go, they also have a specific domain, like mangaloreuniversity.ac.in, like this. Okay, so it will have some specific domain, specific name will be there to understand that particular website, remember. And how, for example, I'm giving example here, like amazon.com, flipkart.com. So here, com stands for the commercial purpose, remember. I will bring some class other, commercial. Commercial means they will generate money, revenue. They can generate money, okay, from this site. Okay, if that is related to .org, means organizations, this is free of cost, you can use. Okay, so this is how it goes. Now if you see the, under the website, whatever the things are there under website, you will get web page. So many web pages will be there. If you go to your college website, so many pages will come. One page, two page, third, four, like pages will come. Okay, so where web pages comes, under the website. And website, where it comes, under the web browser or web server, that is called www server. Okay, from here website gets the content. From this website, web pages are getting content. Isse ye milta hai usko sahayata. Okay, now think, see, the web pages and website are two types, remember. Website and web page. I will be talking web pages in later, next slide. Now understand the website. Website and web pages are mainly two types. One is called as static, and another is called dynamic. Okay, both website as well as web pages. So static in a sense which will be stable. Okay, not getting change always. Dynamic means very frequent in nature, changing in nature. I'll be talking later on. So here I talk regarding the website. What are the point regarding the website? It's a collections of web sources. Okay, like web pages will be there inside the website, or different types of multimedia content will be there, and specific domain. Question pucha ja sakta hai exam mein. Specific domain content, which whether website, web page, all these things. So an answer ban jayega aapka website. Specific domain will be there. Okay. Yes. And inside the website, web pages will be there. And website gets information or the resource from www or web server. I think you are clear with this. Chalo. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay. Now understand the web page. What is web page? See, remember, a website typically made the, see, remember, same point I told, where inside the website, so many web pages will be there at a time. Okay, if you open one page, next page will come. If you go to your college site, the first page is known as, see, remember, the first web page. Question asked 2017. Can you give the answer? First web page is known as DAS. First web page. What is the name of first web page? This question already asked. Pusha gaya tha. First web page. Yes, Harshita. Yes, very good answer. First web page is known as the home page. What is called? First web page is known as the home page. Remember. Okay, question may ask by chance. Oh, and on this home page will be in static in nature. See, it will be static in nature. Means it's very rarely getting changed. When you upload that only on the server, then only it gets changed. Otherwise, it is not going to change. Okay, now see here, it's link. The web page will be a link with together in a current fashion. The website web pages will be getting on link. If you open one web pages, some link will be there like this. If you click there, again new page will get open. Again some new link will be there. If you click there, again new page will get open. So what is telling here? The in web page content, there will be some link, inherent current link, means you cannot see the link very easily. If you click there, it will open. Okay, like a disguise. Now this, see, web pages are two types. Web page, website, same. Statics and dynamic. We need to understand how it is called as, why it is called as static and why it is called as dynamic. So you should understand this part. Okay. So let's see. Now understand the difference between the static website and dynamic website. See, the first point is here. What is telling here? Under statics, kya bola ja raha hai? It is pre-built content. See, this kind of web pages will be pre-built. Mean, matlab iska kya hai? Pehle se banaya gaya hoga. Okay. If you come to, for example, you are a customer. If you come to me, I already will made some content regarding the static, because it will be common. Common to most of the institution, or common to most of the university, or all these things. More or less same will be there. So it is pre-built. I already mailed this. Okay. In case of this dynamic, it is content generated and on the fly. Very, very important. On the fly. Means when customer comes, then only I will make, because it is a demand from the customer. How he need the dynamic page. Maybe this photo will be there. This video will be there. This line will be there. All these things. So many category will be there. Function will be there. Okay, so that is called the dynamic, means every time it's getting changed. For example, one customer want this kind of page, dynamic page. Next customer want some other page. Okay, some other style, some other photo he wants in his site. So it will be dynamic. The first page, which is called home page, that will be static home page. Okay, home page, remember. And this content, static web page content, the changes when the someone uploaded in the publish. See, remember what is telling here. When you upload into the server, your website or your web page, that time only the first page will get changed. First page only, that time only. Okay. But this, what you call dynamic web page is continuously. See, this side is allow the server generate and content pages is loaded. See, it's continuously getting changed, continuous. But here it happen very rarely when you upload into your server, university server or your company server, that time only. But here it will get changed continuous now and then. Okay. Now if you see this static web page will be simple to design, no need to any hurry, worry, nothing is will be simple. Easily it can be designed. And this kind of dynamic web pages takes long time to design, a little bit complicated. Okay, because so many things function will come and go. So it's called little bit difficult, complicated. Okay. Please keep all the points in your mind so that it will be useful for you. Next point C. Next point, what is telling here? The language what we use to make a simple page. Okay, or the static page, that is called as HTML. Already I discussed hypertext markup language and JavaScript application for making the static page. And for the dynamic page, what we use? CGI, AGM, and ASP. I'll write the full name. CGI stands for Computer Generated Imagery. Computer Generated Imagery. Okay, and this form, full form I don't know, cannot remember, but ASP stands for Active Server Page. Okay, so these are the two full form you should remember here. I don't know, you can see, check here later on. Remember, I cannot remember this. So this kind of language will be used to make the dynamic website. Okay, and also not only website, web page also. Okay, so here information change occur very rarely. Here information will change very rarely. Slowly it will get changed very rarely when you upload that only. And here information changes occur frequently. Now and then information is getting changed. Okay, today you show something, tomorrow it will get changed. For example, I think you have seen in your, when you fill any form, if you go to any website, today you fill the form, after a week, few days, the form fill up date gets over, gets changed. Some other new file will come, notice will come. So when all these things happen into the next page, not in home page, home page will be stable as it is. All these things happen next of the home page. So it's frequently getting changed. Okay, and this kind of home page is loading less time. It takes for loading purpose in the server very less time because much more database is not there, very less data. And in case of this dynamic, it takes little more time because so many things will be there, video, audio, everything. So many clips are there. So here, do not use any database. Database will be having very less database. Okay, MB will be very less, GB will be very less. Here it's long, very more. Okay, so these are the very few points you need to understand here. So for your example purpose, आपको समझने के लिए example क्या है? जैसे हमारा है corporate university का जो भी है background है. Background मतलब the first page when they gives about. See, I only mean about the university, about the constitutions or sorry about the institutions. उसका जो background है, mission, visions, all these things comes under first page. Important points, IQ. Okay, any website or any web page, this kind of things come in which page? Background, mission, vision comes in static page or dynamic page. The answer ban jayega aapka static website or static page. Okay, and here upcoming event. So many things will be there. Upcoming event for next week, next month, all these things were dynamic, continuously changing. So these are the important points you need to keep in mind. Chalo aapko yaad mein rakhna padega. Next lecture. क्या बोला जा रहा इधर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट यार द फर्स्ट एवर वेबसाइट फर्स्ट जो पहला वेबसाइट है और अपना वेब पेज है उसको बारे में बोल रहा है द फर्स्ट एवर वेबसाइट इज नोन एज द CRN ओके ऑलरेडी डिस्कस फुल फॉर्म एंड द फर्स्ट वेब पेज इज दिस इज सी इफ आई क्लिक हियर सी लिंक इज गेटिंग जनरेटेड सी यू विल गेट द लिंक सो इट्स द फर्स्ट वेब पेज Okay, who founded? Same person who founded the www, Tim Berners-Lee, when? 1991, when he released the www is for all public people. Okay, so these are the few points you need to understand, keep in mind. I think you are clear, yes. Hum sab kuch to kar liye uske. So these are the few points you need to understand. Next, I'll be talking regarding the web browser, then the search engine and URL. Okay, if you have any doubt and all, you can ask me obviously. So this is my profile, Amiyadas, and we are giving the preparation for the ICT. Then we will be starting people and environment. Then we'll be starting regarding the higher educations. And if you go and research, everything will be bringing. So if you have any doubt, again, thing, you can go for my channel. Yoga channel is there for yoga net preparation purpose, Yogadhi. And if you have any doubt or any clarification, you can comment me at the end of the video, or you can contact me with this email ID. Okay, hope you enjoy this video. Look and watch. Please comment, share and subscribe. Thank you very much. Have a good day. Bye-bye.